All right, rainy day garage work. So I'm building the new 12-volt macro solar generator. I'm going to use some of the parts on this one and incorporate it into this one. Lessons learned on this one, which isn't bad. I like some of the stuff on here. I'm going to put it into this one.
All right, I'm going to walk and talk you through this rebuild of my micro solar generator. See the air inlet vent there? And here's the bottom side, hot glued it in. And that's for the inverter where the fan is. See how the fan is on the bottom there? It sucks in and blows up through the inverter. And what I was concerned about is good airflow inside the box. So that inlet there is right there where the fan is. And here's the cord for the inverter for the AC out. There's the back side. That faceplate cover plate is temporary. That's all I had. And there it is plugged in, and actually sandwiches in nicely when the lid is closed. Helps secure it. Little cable relief so you don't yank it out of the outlet. And here's the Blue Sea Systems 12 circuit fuse block mounted on the Interstate Batteries 35 amp hour AGM deep cycle battery. Spaghetti wiring. And you can pause this and take a better look at these stills. And here's the fan. I installed a little DC blower fan, 12 volt, to blow the air out. And this is really slick here with the SAE connectors for the battery and the solar inputs. It's now on the back side. And here it is out back. Here's the old one there on the bottom. Well, up there now. And here's those SAE connectors, battery to battery paralleling cable. Quick disconnect. And the screws to hold those jacks in, I put those on that side because I didn't want them to poke on the battery on the inside of the box. See there? Here it is all wired up, doing the Arky and Sparky test. These fuse blocks are the way to go. Oh my goodness. So much easier, so much smarter to. It was a breeze wiring this up. The only thing I don't have on the fuse block is the solar input. I got a 15 amp right there. There's the blower fan. That little fan really blows out the hot air. The inverter is now a 300 watt. The old one was 180 watt. Slick inverter. It sits right there, Velcroed in place. There's the Greesonic 15 amp MPPT solar charger Velcroed in there. And down below, I actually have a couple more holes drilled in there. You can see where I got pigtails on the meters. And the switch on the front switches off the battery voltmeter and the fan. Only need one switch. Everything else is just comes on automatically. These are wired in always hot on their own circuit now. And here's the back side. I gotta show you something I really screwed up. Not only is that wood cover ugly as sin, but you know, measure twice, cut once. I'm a quarter inch off. I'm not centered. Oops. Yeah, it looks alright. And lastly, I got some of these new stickers from stickerapp.com. Best prices out there. And here I am just panning around my backyard jungle for you guys. Show you how green everything is back here. Gonna have rain all weekend. Alright guys, hey, thanks for watching. And hope this video inspires you with your builds. See you next time.